charm's a joke you throw. Your love, that's the old way. It's like you're always stuck in second gear. But when it hasn't been your day, hi, I'm Alina.
And I'm Nassim, and welcome to our October episode of NHP TV.
This episode, you'll see our take on Couch Boy,
The Scaring, which is not to be confused with the obviously less terrifying film, The Conjuring,
a highly satirical, scary story set in our very own school,
and Mr. Worldwide himself with a host of other characters.
We hope you enjoyed this month's episode, and on to monthly favorites.
Anna and CJ, back together for the first monthly favorites of this season.
We started off this month with movies like Dune, Venom, Let There Be Carnage, and Diana, the musical, which is a little too relatable right now, Prince Charles.
If you've ever thought to yourself, what would the children's game Red Light, Green Light be with death and cash prizes, then check out Squid Game. Honestly, even if you haven't thought that, check out Squid Game.
I wish you were in Squid Game.
What?
The premiere of Midnight Mass aired on Netflix on September 24th. Season 4 of On My Block premiered on Netflix on October 4th. Season 2 of The Babysitter's Club released on October 11th. And Season 4 of Dynasty came out on Netflix on October 22nd.
Speaking of generational wealth, Lil Wayne and Rich Kid dropped Trust Fund Babies earlier this month. We also had a chance to listen to Meek Mill's Expensive Pain, Coldplay's Music of the Spheres, and Lana Del Rey's Blue Bannisters album.
Later this month, Ed Sheeran is releasing his fourth studio album. I'm not a fan of the title because it's a little too reminiscent of Math Class, but here's the album cover. No, sorry, that's a picture of the artist. Here's the album cover.
We know that this has been a big month for Major League Baseball with playoffs going on. Let's hear it for our baseball fans. Understandable. On to football. The NFL season continued through this month with highly anticipated games like Buccaneers versus Patriots, Bills versus Chiefs, Bills versus Titans, and Lions versus Rams.
If you're one of those kids who refers to football only as sports ball, these updates might be more interesting for you. In the Tony Awards late last month, Moulin Rouge, the musical, won a host of awards, including Best Actor, Best Musical, and an all-too-real story about an English boy who steals a Duke's co-host.
That's just so inaccurate. We need to talk through this.
Oh my god, how can you do this with another host?
Well, that was an eventful monthly favorites. I hope CJ and Couchboy, Anna, figure that out. Anyways, here at NHP TV, we're dedicated to ensuring that the low-lying, all-consuming fear inside you never fully goes away. So Harrison and I took the liberty to scare people around the school campus.
Like that?
Yes, just like that. Have fun watching.
Oh, okay.
We hope you enjoyed that.
Now, on to scary stories.
This viewing is intended for mature audiences. Watch at your own discretion. Welcome to Scary Stories with NHP TV. Less scary stories, more, how do I say this? Investigating. Today, I'll be going into the disappearance of 12 Oaks Cable. I realize this is a very touchy subject for some of us, so I strongly advise that you watch at your own discretion. Anyways, I'll stop stalling. Let's get right. Did you hear that? Okay, that was awfully weird. Should we go investigate? Well, too bad. We're going anyway.
I don't get paid enough for this.
Well, are you coming?
Do I have a choice?
A lot of us took 12 Oaks for granted, me included. But now, all we have are these inedible fruits and vegetables.
Hey, at least lunch is free.
Now who asked you to talk, huh?
MG?
Hello?
Is that you? It's been so long, I haven't seen you since the fall. The fall of 12 Oaks.
Maham, what happened?
I saw it, a silhouette. A man wearing a black windbreaker and devil's horns with long hair.
Hello? Hello, are you okay?
MG? Is that you?
Hari? Is that you?
Listen, you need to leave right now.
No need. I'm right where I need to be.
What?
And I see the pain, the suffering, the cheese, the plastic cheese. Listen, Rogayu, my time is come. I'm going to be one with the cheese, one with the oak. To truly understand, you must experience for yourself. Head to the place far opposite of the west.
House of Lords. The place where it all began.
My precious Hari!
No! Don't go. He's in there.
Who? The 46th President of the United States of America? President Joseph Robin F. Biden Jr.?
No. The demon.
Who is this demon?
I don't know. One second, he's there, a silhouette, and then boom, a flash of lightning.
Have you ever been face to face with this demon?
For this life, I cannot change. That's what it said to me. I need a vacation, I need a replacement. Wait.
Those are Travis Scott lyrics.
Bro, how do you know? Help! Help me, there's a group of aliens trying to probe me in my head!
Hey, focus! What is up with this demon? Hello? Figured it out. I don't have much time though. The person behind all of this, the person behind everything, the disappearance of 12 Oaks, the food, the lightning, it's all because of...
Now, enjoy your food.
Well, that segment had just about everything that's necessary for a good, scary story. Demons, silhouettes, and household fruit. Now, on to part two of The Scaring.
For our final segment, our NHP TV hosts participated in a costume contest, and we want you to judge it.
Ladies and gentlemen and non-binary friends, welcome to Tough Costumers, your favorite costume contest with a twist. It's spooky season, or as I like to call it, spite season. Because the only thing better than free candy is demolishing the competition in an arbitrary contest.
sorry, too much. Anyway, whoever has the best costume as judged by our audience will win the contest and receive a prize.
What do you mean by prize?
Without further ado, let's get into how this works. Each contestant will step up here and show off their little swaggy drip. Let's welcome our first contestant.
Hi, I'm Andrew, and I'm dressed as Jake Peralta from Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Nice.
Yeah, nice costume, Andrew. I mean, so I got a question for you.
Yes.
Why Jake Peralta?
Because he is my inspiration, and I want to be just like him when I grow up.
So you want to be a pretty bad cop?
Toit. Nice.
All right, guys, that's Andrew. Let's get our next contestant in here.
Hi, everyone. My name's Bragayu, and I'm dressed up as Vector.
Nice one. Nice one. Real good one. So, Vector, what inspired you to do this costume? Why Vector? Why not Gru, or why not a minion?
Because vectors have magnitude and direction.
Was that from Miss Raja?
Come on, that's from Despicable Me.
But was that directed for Miss Raja?
Yes. Miss Raja, if you're watching, this is for you.
Thank you. Thank you, Margayu.
Thank you.
Our next contestant is already here. Hello, what's your name and who are you dressed as?
I'm Pranav, and I'm dressed up as Loki.
Loki, that's a pretty good costume. So, tell me, Pranav, why do you think you're going to be the one to win this costume contest?
Because of my hair. That's it.
You heard him, folks. Vote for him. For his hair, I guess. Bye. Now that we've seen Loki, I think it's time to introduce our next contestant. So who are you? What are you dressed as?
I'm Harrison, and I'm dressed as Michael Myers.
Oh, so you got any victims, or how's that going?
My last victim was the Chili's bathroom.
You heard him, folks. Don't use the bathroom at Chili's. Get out of here, please. After that bathroom fiasco, I think we need someone to clean it up. So we got our favorite Marvel character here, Black Widow.
What's the sitch?
Hello, who are you? Who are you dressed as, Black Widow?
My name is Alina, and actually, I'm dressed as Kim Possible.
Sometimes mistakes happen. So, Kim Possible, tell us about your hair routine. How'd you do it? Did you just wake up that fabulous?
No, of course not. This takes precision, time, dedication, money, a mouse, a sidekick. It takes the work of many people, and it's fabulous as it is.
Would you like to do a little twirl?
Of course.
Well, that's it, folks. That's Kim Possible for ya. Now let's get our next contestant in here. Get over here. Name, costume.
Hello, my name is Anna, and I'm dressed as Miss Universe. But is it okay if I have somebody else with me?
Hey, producers, is that okay?
Dale.
Okay, I think we can do this. So, Miss Universe, who is this figure?
I'm Mr. 305.
Mr. Worldwide? We got Mr. Worldwide out here, folks. All right, so first question for the both of you. How'd you guys meet? What's the story?
You know, she might...
Valentine's in a nutshell, am I right? All right, Miss Universe. If you had to solve inequality, gender inequality, what would you do?
Boys go to Jupiter to get more stupider. Girls go to Mars to get more cars.
Mr. Worldwide, anything to add on to that?
We at the Hotel Motel Holiday Inn.
Hey, if you missed the Pitbull concert, we got it right here for you, folks. This is NHP TV Premium. All right, you two, have a great night. Now get out of here.
Work for us.
After that great couples contest, I think we got another one for you, folks. Get in here.
Hey, Puddin.
Hi. Name? Costume?
CJ. Harley Quinn.
So, I thought this was gonna be some sort of Harley Quinn Joker situation. No Joker?
I killed him.
Well, we got it. We got murder confessions on here now. All right, CJ, last question for you today. If you were to win this contest, what do you think that'll bring you?
More voices in my head.
All right, folks, I think he's going straight to a mental asylum now. And to finish it off, we have the most elaborate, the least done costume in the entire world. Bring it in here. All right, name, costume?
I'm Hari, and I think I'm dead.
I think that you got inspiration for your costume from somewhere. You know where?
Hi, my name is Sunita Mata. I am 24 years old, and I am here to win.
You were less dead last year.
I'm more dead now.
Okay, no, we're not. I'm the better ghost. We're not gonna have that competition right now. But I think before we end the entire segment, the last question for you, Hari Ghost, is if you were to win, would you haunt us?
No.
Well, you heard it straight from the ghost man. Well, folks, those were certainly some interesting costumes. Some were good, some were bad. Some made me question my life choices. But what really matters is your opinion. Be sure to cast your vote down in the comments by October 31st so that we can give one lucky host our super special prize.
Why did you use finger quotes when you said prize?
And that wraps up our first episode of the Tough Costumers. This show was brought to you by the Delirious Teenagers and was approved by no one. See you next time.
Click here to subscribe and click here to watch our latest videos. As always, we're keeping you up to speed only at NHPTV.